Hello. This video will cover Q Auto's features, ranging from how to calibrate the system to removing the rear wheel and tips for troubleshooting. For more information and guidance, please visit bike.shimano.com. Let's dive into the important features of Q Auto. The Q Auto system can automatically shift to the right gear for you. If you're headed up a hill, Q Auto can make your life easier so you can relax and let Q Auto help you while you enjoy the view. The great thing about Q Auto is that it only performs one shift at a time, so you don't have to worry about shifting shock or chain breakage. Let's take a look at the second feature. No battery, so no charging. That's right. Q Auto charges simply by using a dynamo in the rear hub of your bike. That means you can hop on your bike whenever you like and not worry about charging your electronic shifting system. Finally, there's Q Auto's adaptive learning feature. The Q Auto system uses an AI learning function to adapt to your style of riding. How? Besides automatic shifting, Q Auto can be operated manually by using your shifter switch on your handlebar. Over time, Q Auto will adapt to your shifting behavior, and you will experience your bike shifting for you, just when you were about to do it. After only 6 kilometers of cycling, your bike will already begin to apply what it has learned from your style of cycling. If your bike doesn't have manual shifting options, you can still set Q Auto to your preferred shifting mode. Simply double press 1, 2, the button on your rear derailleur. Here, to toggle mode 1 for slow pedaling mode, mode 2 is middle pedaling mode, and mode 3 is fast pedaling mode. Check your current mode by briefly pressing the button on the rear derailleur. If the LED light blinks once, this means you are in slow pedaling mode. If it blinks twice, you're in middle pedaling mode. 3 blinks means you're in fast pedaling mode. Prefer fully manual riding? No problem. Press the third button on your shifting switch to toggle fully manual mode, so you can enjoy your own preferred operation. Now that we've covered Q Auto's key benefits, it's time to talk about calibration. Now, proper calibration is crucial for comfortable automatic shifting. Let's get started. First, make sure your bike is on a flat surface area. Rotate the wheel to start the system. The LED will flash green. Now, stop the wheel. Press the rear derailleur button for 5 to 8 seconds to start calibration. The LED on the rear derailleur will start flashing green and yellow to indicate calibration is standby. Now you can release the button to begin. The button will flash green 5 times to indicate that the calibration has been successful. If the LED button flashes red, this means calibration was not successful. If this happens, check if the wheel was completely still when the button started flashing. The wheel needs to be still when you start calibrating. And don't forget to check if your bike is on a flat, level surface. Let's move to setting up the bike for your first ride. Usually your bike will be set up to the proper tire circumference, rear gear information, and front chain ring tooth number by the manufacturer. In the event that you need to change your settings, simply use the Customize tab of the eTube Project Cyclist app on your smartphone to set your bike to your desired specifications. Don't forget to check that your app has been updated to version 5.2 or newer. Got the right version? Great! Go ahead and press that button on your RD to connect to eTube. Now you can customize your bike settings by selecting gear shifting, auto shift, set your tire circumference, the number of rear derailleur speeds, the number of teeth on the front chain ring, and the cassette configuration. Press next. Now select the start gear position. Press apply. Now disconnect, and you're good to go. At all times, remember that when in doubt, you should visit your local Shimano service center with certified mechanics trained to help you get the best out of your Q Auto system. Sometimes you might need to remove or replace a wheel. A flat tire or any kind of servicing may require removal of the back wheel. For this next section, let's see how you can remove the back wheel of the Q Auto and put it back on. You will need to have the following tools to remove a Q Auto wheel: a TL-EW300 cable tool, and, for wheels that don't have a quick release lever, a hex key. If you don't have these tools yourself, please visit your local Shimano dealer for assistance. To begin with, just like any bike, make sure your bike is in the top gear. That's the heaviest. With Q Auto, there are two ways to do this. If you have a shifter switch, you can use it to shift up to the top gear. You can also simply lift the wheel, use your hand to pedal, and watch the automatic shifting system shift to the top gear. After you have shifted to the top gear, remove the free hub cable using the tool. Cable removed. Great. Now grab hold of the wheel while you remove the through axle. Holding onto the wheel is important to keep it from falling. Through axle removed. Now you can release the wheel, making sure to press the rear derailleur back lightly to help the wheel come free from the cassette. Ready to put the wheel back in? Great! Make sure the free hub cable is hanging down as you place the chain back over the top gear of the cassette. Hold the rear derailleur like you see here, and pop the wheel in. Place the through axle back in the wheel and tighten it. Connect the free hub cable to the rear derailleur. Finally, you must calibrate your Q Auto system each time you remove the wheel. Rotate the wheel to start the system. The LED will flash green. Now, stop the wheel. Press the rear derailleur button for 5 to 8 seconds to start calibration. The LED on the rear derailleur will start flashing green and yellow to indicate calibration is standby. Now you can release the button to begin. The button will flash green 5 times to indicate that the calibration has been successful. In case your bike is in manual mode, if your bike has not been used for more than a year, or if you encounter some issue causing the automatic shifting system to malfunction, you can follow these steps to resolve the issue. First, check the LED on your rear derailleur to see the automatic shifting status. To see the status, either rotate the back wheel or press the button on the back of the rear derailleur. If the LED lights green once for 3 seconds and once for 2 seconds, this means the system is in manual mode and automatic shifting is disabled. Change to automatic shifting mode by double pressing the rear derailleur button. Or you can press the third button on your shifter to toggle auto mode. The green LED should now light once, twice, or 3 times depending on the auto mode you have selected. This will show that auto mode is enabled. If the LED lights red for 3 seconds, this means the system does not have enough electric power to shift gears. You can recharge the system by rotating the rear wheel. After a few minutes, the LED will turn green. Normally, the system should generate enough power to function properly, but if the rider shifts manually too often or continuously turns and stops the wheel, the power might decrease. If you press the rear derailleur button and no light shows at all, this means there is a separate issue. You can check if the cable connecting the free hub to the rear derailleur is properly secured. If you still encounter issues, please visit your local Shimano dealer or Shimano service center, where experienced mechanics can help you. That's it. We hope you enjoyed this video. QAuto is our revolutionary new system that allows electronic and automatic shifting without charging. Enjoy the ride!